At the start of every year, the Electricity Regulatory Authority sets end user tariffs in consideration of different factors such as performance of the shilling against the dollar, inflation and international fuel prices. This year's tariff reduction of the tariff by 1.2% was due to improved performance of the Uganda shilling against the dollar.
Uganda shilling has appreciated against the United States dollar from 3,810 shillings and 70 cents per dollar in the termination of the retail tariff for the fourth quarter of 2022 to shillings 3,738.33 on the 30th November 2022, as published by the Bank of Uganda. This represents an appreciation of 1.9%.
For a sector that relies on imported inputs, this means that players will need less shillings to purchase the dollar in the international market to be able to procure the inputs. Domestic consumers will pay 808.9 shillings for every unit consumed. This represents a 12 shilling reduction from 820.9 shillings that domestic consumers paid between October and December last year. However, a domestic consumer will pay 250 shillings for the first 15 units purchased every month. Commercial consumers such as supermarkets, welders and salons will pay 624.6 shillings a unit, a reduction from 637.7 shillings the previous quarter. Medium industrialist tariff was reduced by 2.1% from 482.3 shillings to 472.3 shillings. Large industrialist tariff was reduced by 0.6% from 388.5 shillings to 386.3 shillings. On the other hand, extra large industrialist tariff was reduced from 328.5 shillings to 326.6 shillings.
People who consume power in bulk, 1.2% reduction is a lot. If you are not consuming in bulk, you may not feel it. It's like these people who are wholesalers, those who sell cement in bulk. Ask them how much they get per bag of cement or a bag of sugar. Just, I think, 200 shillings. But if you are selling in bulk, that's 200 shillings, even 50 shillings.
A section of industrialists has welcomed the move, describing it as a step in the right direction, especially at a time when companies are faced by economic hardships. Report by Benon Ojambo for the news in Kampala.